In this video, we are going to discuss how to draw polar plot or Nyquist plot for type 1 and order 3 system. So now we can see the transfer function given to draw polar plot or Nyquist plot. This is the transfer function. G of s is equivalent to 1 by s into st1 plus 1, 1 plus st2. This is the transfer function given. For this, we need to draw the polar plot or Nyquist plot. So, for this, to draw polar plot or Nyquist plot, first, if you want to estimate the plot is going to take place in which coordinate, you need to refer this diagram. So, this already I given when I am introducing polar plot and Nyquist plot for you. And here, this is type 0, type 1, type 2, type 3 coordinates. And here, if the system is type 0 order 1, then this will starts and ends in this same coordinate. If the system is type 0 and order 2, so the polar plot starts here and ends in this coordinate. If the system is type 1 and order 3, then this polar plot starts at here and ends in this coordinate. For example, so here type 2 order 3, then both starts and ends in this coordinate. Like this we can trace our polar plot. Now for this, for given transfer function, if you want to trace in which coordinate your polar plot is going to take place, for that you need to calculate type and order of the system. Now if you see, type of the system can be decided by the number of poles at origin. Who will decide the number of poles at origin? Means the singlest term in the denominator of the sinusoidal transfer function will decide how many poles are there at origin. If s is there, we can say one pole is there at origin. If s square is there, then we can say two poles are at origin. Here I am having only single s, so that's why I am saying this is type 1 system. Coming to order, so order is nothing but maximum value of s power we are having in the denominator polynomial. So here in this denominator, so maximum value of s power we can get here is s cube only, not more than that. So that's why, so this is order 3 system. So type 1 order 3 polar plot or Nyquist plot starts here and ends in this coordinate. So this is our just tracing. Generally to draw we need to have some calculations. If you are writing any technical exam, to trace from the options, definitely you can use this method. General method to draw polar plot or Nyquist plot is to calculate magnitude and phase. We need to calculate magnitude of the transfer function and we need to calculate phase of the transfer function. If you consider that magnitude versus phase plot, so that is called as our polar plot. So now you can see, so here I am going to consider g of j omega. So that means in place of s I am considering j omega. So 1 by j omega into j omega t1 plus 1, 1 plus j omega t2. So now here if you want magnitude, magnitude can be calculated by considering modulus of g of j omega. That means modulus of the transfer function is nothing but magnitude. So this is equivalent to 1 by, so here omega root of, omega root of, so for this the modulus, for j omega modulus is omega. For j omega t1 plus 1 the modulus is 1 plus omega square t1 square. For this term the modulus is root of a square minus b square. So here j is there. So that's why I am considering a square plus b square form. 1 plus omega square t2 square. So this is your magnitude of the given transfer function. Now here phase, coming to phase, phase is equivalent to, here I am having j omega term in denominator, j omega frequency, in frequency response analysis itself I told you that if you are having j omega term in denominator, the phase related to that j omega term will be minus 90 degrees. For example, if you are having same j omega term in numerator, then the phase angle related to that j omega term in numerator will be plus 90. But here we are having j omega term in denominator, so you can treat the phase angle related to that term as minus 90 degrees. Minus 90, coming to this term, 1 by j omega t1 plus 1. For this term, the phase angle formula is tan inverse b by a. So here, if this is in a plus jb form, then the phase angle is tan inverse minus b, that means omega t1 by 1 minus tan inverse or tan inverse minus b by a. So already I taken minus here, so that's why tan inverse b by a means omega t1 minus, here also like that, tan inverse omega t2. So this is the phase angle of the given transfer function. Whenever we are having both magnitude and phase angle in this, for this transfer function, we can easily draw the polar plot by varying omega from 0 to omega infinity. By varying omega from 0 to infinity, we can draw the polar plot by taking magnitude versus phase. When omega is equivalent to 0, what about the magnitude? You can see, if omega is equivalent to 0, 0 into anything is equivalent to 0. 1 by 0 is equivalent to infinity. So magnitude will be equivalent to infinity when omega is equivalent to 0. When omega is equivalent to 0, what about the phase angle? So phase angle is equivalent to omega equivalent to 0 means tan inverse 0, tan inverse 0. Tan inverse 0 is 0. Minus 90 degrees, minus 0 degrees, minus 0 degrees. So the phase angle, resultant phase angle at omega is equivalent to 0 will be minus 90 degrees. Coming to omega is equivalent to infinity, that means the ending point where it is going to end. As this is order 3 system, this is going to end here, means minus 270 degrees. So here omega is equivalent to infinity means, let's come to magnitude. So 1 by infinity, infinity into anything infinity. So 1 by infinity is 0, magnitude will be 0. Coming to phase angle, minus 90, tan inverse infinity, tan inverse infinity. Tan inverse infinity means 90 degrees, and here 90 degrees. Minus 90, minus 90, minus 90. So totally 270 degrees phase angle we are having it to omega is equivalent to infinity. By taking these two magnitude phase combinations, we can plot Nyquist plot. So the polar plot or Nyquist plot for this is, so 0 degrees plus 90, 180. So this is 270, again 360. Minus 90 means 270 degrees, or minus 270 is 90 degrees. 180 is this, minus 180 means 0 degrees. 360 is here, minus 360 means you can take like this. So general coordinates will be like this, 0, 90, 180, 270. So now you can see, at omega is equivalent to 0, you need to touch infinity. As this is type 1 system, so you need to consider this line, 270 degrees line or type 1 system line. So the value is infinity, so I can't touch this line. I am not making, so my plot will be like this with 90 degrees. The direction is upwards. The direction is upwards. But I can't touch this line. I can't touch this type 1 line or 270 degrees line. Why? Because I don't know where infinity point is there, because my magnitude is infinity. But this plot need to touch at the magnitude, but I don't know the magnitude. But I know it's taking 90 degrees. So that's why I'm considering 90 degrees angle. So minus 90 degrees means 270 only. So on minus 90 degrees plane, so 270 means minus 90, plus 90, minus 90. On minus 90 degrees plane, it need to touch at infinity. As I don't know infinity point, I am leaving this branch as it is. And this keep on increasing with omega increasing. With increasing omega, it keep on increasing in this direction. It will goes to this coordinate as order is equivalent to 3. So, you can see here, if you don't know this also, at omega is equivalent to infinity, you need to touch minus 270 degrees line at 0. So, this is 270, minus 270 degrees line means plus 90. So, you need to touch minus 270 degrees line at 0 means you need to go here and touch here like this. So, the direction will be like this. You can see. So, according to this or this, your plot will be like this. So, this is the polar plot of type 1 order 3 system. So, this is the meaning. At minus 90 degrees line, you need to touch infinity. As I don't know the infinity value to touch, so I can't touch here. For example, if you got 1 here, you can touch this minus 90 degrees line, you can make that omega as is equivalent to 1 or magnitude is equivalent to 1. For example, for the same plot, so if this is 1, then you can write like this. This is 1, this is at omega equal to 0. You need to mention like this for any other problem. Same type 1 and order 3 system. For example, if you got magnitude is equivalent to 1, at omega is equivalent to 0, 1 at an angle of minus 90, maybe for some problems you will get like that. So, then you need to consider like this, at minus 90 degrees line, you need to touch at point 1 when omega is equivalent to 0. You need to represent like this. And you need to touch this minus 270 degrees line at 0. So, you need to go to minus 270 degrees and you need to touch here. You can see as this is type 1, order 3. So, type 1 is here and order 3 here. It will covers these two coordinates. Starts at this coordinate type 1, starts at type 1 and ends in this coordinate where order 3 is there. So, like this, we need to draw polar plot for type 1 order 3 system.